He went in and tried to get himself in the spot for his shot. Enough might do it for him, but he goes the other way instead. And at the side of the net, scramble, and the Chicago Blackhawks in a little trouble right there, but he got the puck along the boards. It won't get out. Lupo was bodied trying to get inside that Chicago blue line. Liddy takes over. Lost it. Oh, and a save by Ronta. Got the right pad out, made a big stop. But Koska was there for the Chicago Blackhawks, he and Nick Liddy, the two defensemen. They don't get it out. Another shot, but a save and a big rebound. Again, another stop by Ronta. Cleared along the boards by Chicago. Taves got it out, and he's fast. Coming in, he's going to get a shot. And that's stopped by Bernier on the short side. Chicago's first shot by the very dangerous Jonathan Taves. Takes a look around. He sees Holland going. He carries the puck in, drops it back to Raymond. Centering pass near the line. Ends up at the stick of Gardner. In again. And at the side of the net, what a chance! Score! Holland was right there, and nobody could move on him before it was in the back of the net. Power play goal. Toronto leads 1-0.
Excellent puck movement by the Toronto Maple Leafs on this power play. Now what I like about this play, they get the puck down low quickly. Lupo's going to be off to the right of Ronta. Here's the pass, it just slides out. Oduya stops the first pass across to Holland.
Puck is played across the line. That long shot doesn't reach the net. Hit a leg. Lupo got it back again. Here's Riley galloping in. Plays it back. The shot. Big rebound is cleared away by the Chicago Blackhawks. And it barely gets out. But the Leafs come close to getting their second goal. Blackhawks back with Duncan Keith. Lost it. Toronto for checking well. Right in front of the net. Here's another shot by Kessel. He nearly got a third. Two big saves by Ronta. He stayed with him. So they're back in their own zone and starting up. The all-star defenseman, Duncan Keith. Coming in hard as sharp. Right in front of the net. Gunnarsson couldn't get it all the way out, but he made a good play clearing the danger area. Lots of time to set it up. Stays open for a shot, maybe. Nope, side of the net. Score! It was fired at the net by Patrick Kane, all right. And the goalie wasn't quite ready. Off a skate in front of him, and he couldn't do much about it. Dion Phaneuf got his skate down, or was, I don't know if it was a stick or a skate, it hit it anyway and went in on the goalie.
Well, everybody in the building saw this play developing. Kane in the corner, you know he's going to try and go cross crease because it's a smart play. And you're going to see Dion Phaneuf stick his stick in there, thinking in an attempt to block that pass. And there it is, and Jonathan Bernier, of course, has no chance on that one.
All the sticks are in the right spot. Kane, left-handed shot, he's got a good angle. He's going backdoor to a right-handed shot.
And the time left in the first penalty. So they're still shorthanded, these Toronto Maple Leafs, and the game is tied now in Chicago's power play. Powerful, Seabrook. Raise the goalpost with that hard shot from the line. The Maple Leafs pick it up quickly. McClemens brings it on. Nick White pass doesn't quite work, however, they carry on.
Right in front, they score!
Jerry Demigo got the rebound and poked it home early in the second period. And the Maple Leafs lead 2-1.
A sloppy start to the second period for the Chicago Blackhawks. They give up the blue line too easily right there. And Duncan Keith just lets his player, Demigo, slide in behind him. Tough shot by the Leafs at right here. Kuhlman that Ronta lost sight of, just got sight of it at the last second. That's why there's a juicy rebound.
Going to the net, 36 seconds, no, make that 42 seconds into the second period. Kessel ripped the pass in there quickly and hits for the net. He tipped it right at the goalie, Ronta, who stayed on his skates again and made the save. Tempted shot from the boards, easily yep. Blocked. Right back to the line it comes, and that long shot by Koska was stopped. The Leafs get it out. There goes Holland. He's in on goal, right in. Shot is high, and Ronta makes a save again. Right to the middle to center ice that pass. Patrick Kane turns back to Keith, who came up there. He dropped it. They're all together, this crowd. Coming in is Kane, right in. Nice save by Bernier as Kane broke through. Beautiful passing between the two of them. And the captain for the Maple Leafs got their head of them, but they don't clear it out. Scrambled for it, knocked down in front of the net, and in the goal, but it's going to be waved off. Immediately waved off by the ref skating around the net.
So a puck up in the air right there. And then it hits Dion Phaneuf's stick. That hits Hossa's hand.
Right away, immediately. Stands, of course. There's Mr. Peel. He made the call. Coming on to center with the pass. Up to Luke, and he threw it in there. Right in, score! Peter Holland gets the goal on a three-way passing play. And a dandy passing play it was. And the Leafs open up a two-goal lead. 3-1.
You don't often see Duncan Keith and Brent Seabrook being minus two in a period, but here it is. Leafs again using that speed that we talked about. Nifty little play right at the blue line. And then just not the back check that they needed by the Chicago Blackhawks, and that's why Holland was left alone.
Well, we talked about the last shift that Hossa had. It was a two-minute shift. That's too long. And
the shot lost the puck. Riley takes off. Got a pass away. That doesn't work. Backhand for Kane. Coming to the net. Shoot! Score! Patrick Kane coming in there, and he took his time and looked for the opening. And he found it. 3-2, Toronto.
Johnny Oduya kept this puck alive for the Chicago Blackhawks. So right at the point right there, just throws it in. And Shaw loses the puck. Now Riley thinks he can head up ice, so he's going to head man the puck. Good play by Jalmerson, notice. Read that play and just push that puck ahead to Patrick Kane.
Well, it's been three or four shifts where the Leafs have turned the puck over. You've got to be aware of the score, the clock, and who you're on the ice with. And you cannot turn it over against Patrick Kane.
Partially blocked, and there wasn't much on it. Toronto in before checking. McClement played it along the boards. It got back a little bit near the line. Back in going. Sharp angle. Coleman scores! Coleman with a pass right on his tape. And rifled a high shot home behind Antti Raanta. And the Leafs lead 4-2.
Now that's a way to come back after giving up a goal. This third line with McClement, D'Amico, and Kuhlman, excellent along the boards. Quick puck movement. They get the Chicago Blackhawks defenseman running around a little bit. Just nice little pass by McClement coming up right here. Spots.
Toronto moving on. Crowd getting Lupul over the line, and he nearly got in for a shot. Lupul played it around the goal. It gets to Raymond on the other side. He's caught, got it out. Shot from there, scored! Jake Gardner took the shot from the line. And Lupul got a stick on it. So, it's a second period for Toronto. 5-2 now.
Mason Raymond with great vision in the corner. He spots Gardner at the point. This is all set up because Joffrey Lupul had great speed and power entering the zone. And then right there's that through the seam pass. There's Lupul right in front, gets his stick.
Holland was in front. He couldn't get the puck out to him, so Holland comes in to help. Lupul and Holland. Holland to Lupul. The shot scored! My goodness, your first game in your life. And there's the first shot, and it's in the net. Toronto leads 6-2.
Randy Carlyle this morning is saying that, boy, he wants Joffrey Lupul to get his game back. He's trying hard to, because what he can do is he's so good down low, good at cycling the puck. Little give and go with Holland right here, gets open. And a quick little wrister, and boy, you've got to really feel for Kent Simpson.
Well, what I like here too, Kelly, is you don't often see a cycle shift for the Leafs. So they provide the cycle shift back of the net, and it's against the top line.
Shaw got back to take it back for Chicago. Bumped on that play. Hassan. Leafs get a break. Holland right in. Nice save by Simpson. Holland centered it at the side of the net. Again was saw, and he couldn't quite knock it down. Centering pass doesn't get in front of the net. Blackhawks play it back to the blue line. Letty scores! The shot hit something in front. Letty took the shot all right. It hit something before it got to the net, and it went in 6-3.
Glenn, you're asking who might of those three get their first hat trick. Well, Saad with the turnover right here. Lupo headman pass, and here's Holland with two goals already. Ken Simpson stays with him nicely. That's why Holland didn't get his hat trick.
You had mentioned, talked to Patrick Sharp at the beginning of the game, and who did he say was one of the most underrated players for the Chicago Blackhawks? Saad, and he gets the goal there. Great deflection, great eye hand.
So look out, Chicago, when you Kessel got a break there. It came outside the line, though, so they get back on side, and Kadri comes in. Centered into Kessel, scores! What a play by Kadri, and what a play by Kessel. So the Leafs were scored on, and now they storm back and get another goal. And it's 7-3, Toronto.
The Leafs are loving this one, aren't they? They're getting lots of scoring chances. They're out shooting somebody for a change. They're attacking the net every chance, and there's that little pass by Kadri. And you know it's that spot on the ice against a rookie goaltender playing his first ever game that Kessel's going to be shooting that on net.
The Toronto Maple Leafs defeat the Chicago Blackhawks 7-3. What a night for the Leafs.